Monca Nation Lingua Franca recently picked up the Best Narrative Film Award at this year's Bentonville Film Festival. But today we speak to the film's director and star, Isabel Sandoval, to tell us more about this really compelling and unique film that talks about a Filipina transgender who's also undocumented trying to stay here in the United States. Welcome to Adobo Nation at Home, Isabel. Maraming salamat sa iyo.
Hi, Ginger. Thank you so much for having me here in Adobo Nation. Yeah, Lingua Franca, it's my third feature film, although it is my first to be shot in and set in the U.S., in New York City. And, you know, this film is a very personal work to me. Just like Ginger said, it's about a Filipina trans woman immigrant in New York City. And I wanted to make, you know, a different kind of Filipino film. You know, when you think about art house Filipino cinema, especially, you know, films that I've played in Cannes, mm-hmm. Berlin, and Venice, there's a certain type where it's kind of a gritty, handheld docudrama mm-hmm. that, you know, set in the slums in Manila. And I wanted to make a film like Lingua Franca, where although on paper it sounds like, you know, a typical social issue drama, it touches on immigration and the transgender experience. I also infuse it with lyricism, you know, delicacy and sensuality. And mm-hmm. I'm really, really excited that it's going to be on Netflix August 26th through Array Distribution and Ava DuVernay.
Well, there's so many things to talk about here, including the it being picked up by Array. And of course, streaming. But I just want to go back quickly to, you know, the message that you really want to drive home. There are many issues that are talked about. There's, you know, the transgender experience. There's immigration is also obviously a big part of the film. What is it that you really wanted to highlight or, you know, shed some light on that hasn't been done before with previous films?
Certainly. You know, as a member of both the Filipino community and the trans community here in the US, I really felt that it was important to shine a light on the experience, you know, of our communities, especially in American cinema where, you know, our stories tend to be invisible mm-hmm. and never get to be heard. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I think there's something truly powerful and radical about getting a film like this made, especially in our current cultural and political moment, mm-hmm. you know, when there are a lot of minorities that are being oppressed and we're literally 3 months away from an election that's going to be very pivotal and significant.
Very important. Oo nga. Ano yung mga misconception you think, Isabel, that maybe the general public has about the immigrant experience and the transgender immigrant experience?
Certainly. I mean, I think it's very tempting to think of, you know, the trans and immigrant experience as being, you know, relentlessly dour and hopeless and desperate. I mean, to a certain extent, there is some truth to that. And I portray that aspect of the experience sa Lingua Franca. But I also wanted to show that there is hope and tenderness mm-hmm. and more than anything else, Lingua Franca is a story of resilience and survival, which I think is a quality and attribute that really distinguishes us Filipinos. We are, if I'm correct, either the second or third largest immigrant group here in the United States. And yeah, I think there's just something truly inspiring and empowering about that. And that's what I wanted to showcase in a film like Lingua Franca.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It's wonderful that, you know, you have this platform that is that can amplify, you know, the voice of yourself as a Filipino American. But I do want to talk about that platform because it's exactly kind of, I think, what people of color need, right? A place to amplify their voices. You were picked up by Array. The distribution, Ava DuVernay's distribution company, arts and distribution company. Ano yung feeling ng nalaman mo? Paano mo nalaman? How did they find you? And, you know, just tell us about, how much that means to you, how significant.
Yeah, I mean, it was surreal experience getting that email from Tulane, who's the president of Array, because of course it's Ava, and Ava, you know, who's, aside from being an extraordinary filmmaker, she's, you know, always been a champion of and amplified the voices of underrepresented filmmakers through Array. You know, women filmmakers, creators of color, and Array itself has a stellar stable of films that it's released, including Jezebel by Noah Perrier, Burning Cane by Philip Yeomans from Tribeca last year. So it's just a thrilling and exhilarating, you know, feeling to be part of that family. I mean, I'm very, very proud and honored to be part of the Array family. And I think, you know, it just goes to show that although we are minority filmmakers, if we band together and reach out and support each other, there is so much we can do and the possibilities are endless.
That's right. Absolutely. Now, and we want to congratulate you because from what I understand, you are the first Filipina American to be part of that roster of talented directors. So I've got to ask, does that put a little bit more pressure on you in your work in the future and, you know, the kind of stories that you want to tell?
Pressure to a certain degree, yes, but it's also, you know, such an amazing vote of confidence because, you know, I want my story and the journey that Lingua Franca has been on to inspire and encourage other Filipino American creators and artists to just, you know, do your thing. Mm-hmm. Tell the story that you want to tell, take risks, you know, be ambitious in your storytelling because this is our moment and we're just getting started.
Great. That's wonderful advice, not just to filmmakers, but to so many people in our community who, you know, may feel intimidated to put themselves out there. You're just telling them to go for it, right? And you never know. Well, it's a part of your dream come true, I'm sure. You know, I can imagine a Lingua Franca is going to be streaming on Netflix on the 26th. Tell us a little bit more about what we can expect there and maybe the future for Lingua Franca.
Yes, so Netflix, Lingua Franca will be premiering on Netflix North America, August 26th. And it continues its festival run in Europe. You know, it premiered last year at the Venice International Film Festival, and it happened to be the first trans woman director to compete in Venice in 76 years. It's had quite a terrific festival run in Europe. And in fact, we actually opened in over 100 cinemas in France last July to great reviews. So, you know, it's found a home and streaming in North America, but it continues its festival journey elsewhere in the world.
That's fantastic. I know. And my last question before I have to let you go, I know it's been a couple years since you've been back home. May mga plano ba na dadali mo rin ang Lingua Franca sa Philippines or anything specific for the Filipino audience?
Yes. I actually went to the Philippines in October for the Philippine premiere of Lingua Franca at Q Cinema, and we are now talking with some potential distributors. And I also just wanted to shout out Front Row Entertainment, TBA, and my producers, Jet Tolentino, who's a Tony and Grammy Award-winning Broadway producer, Carla Vallejo and Darlene Malimas for making the film happen.
Oh, wonderful. Regards to Jet Tolentino. We've actually spoken to him before in the Philippines. It's great to know that you guys are collaborating. So we look forward to more work from you, Isabel. Mabuhay ka, and your stories. So exciting. Thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, Ginger, and thank you for having me on the show.